In the 1980s, as the Soviet Union's nuclear capabilities continued to pose a significant threat to the world, the United States Army launched an effort to develop a helicopter that could take the place of several other aircraft worn down by the strain of the Korean and Vietnam Wars. Enter the RAH-66 Comanche, a twin-engine, two-pilot, stealth-armed reconnaissance and attack helicopter with state-of-the-art avionics and an impressive weaponry system. Despite never getting off the ground, elements of the program still live on, and another Boeing-Sikorsky joint effort is in the works. An urgent upgrade. Throughout the 1980s, the Soviet Union continued to be a palpable and real threat to the United States Department of Defense. However, after decades of use in several conflicts, America's defense aircraft were in dire need of an upgrade. Aware that their arch-nemesis was still spending outstanding amounts of money on technological advances, the United States Army formed the Light Helicopter Experimental Program, or LHX, to work on a viable replacement for their Vietnam-era light attack and reconnaissance helicopters. The LHX had one primary purpose: to field a single rotorcraft that could replace all of the Army's working helicopters, such as the Bell UH-1 Iroquois, the Bell AH-1 Cobra, the Hughes OH-6 Cayuse, and the Bell OH-58 Kiowa. However, the program evolved throughout the decade. By 1988, when the Army released a request for proposal to several manufacturers, the request had transformed into a battlefield reconnaissance helicopter. Near the end of the decade, the Army announced that two teams, Bell McDonnell Douglas and Boeing Sikorsky, had met the requirements for their request for proposal, and the companies were given contracts and money to further develop their designs. After a lengthy trial process, the Army announced in 1991 that the Boeing-Sikorsky engineers had won a $2.8 billion contract to begin production on six prototypes under the official designation RAH-66 Comanche. This Boeing-Sikorsky effort was intended to work as a reconnaissance and light attack vertical aircraft. To meet the Army's demands, the Comanche needed to have powerful armor and weaponry to engage with similar targets, as well as a state-of-the-art navigation and radar system to identify more advanced aircraft. The first prototype assembly began in November of 1993 at Sikorsky's facilities in Connecticut and eventually moved to Boeing's manufacturing plant in Pennsylvania. The following year, the Department of Defense reduced their budget to pay troop salaries, and only two prototypes were requested. On May 25, 1995, the first RAH-66 Comanche prototype was officially unveiled at Sikorsky's production facilities. After the rollout, the aircraft was transferred to Florida to commence flight testing activities. The Comanche. To be more efficient than the other helicopters, the Comanche borrowed design elements from already existing fixed-wing stealth platforms, like the Lockheed F-117 Nighthawk twin-engine stealth attack aircraft. The Comanche's primary mission was to scout the skies with advanced sensors to locate and designate targets for attack helicopters like the AH-64 Apache to strike. The RAH-66's fuselage was 43 feet long and built with composite materials designed to fit onto transport ships, enabling the aircraft to quickly deploy to flashpoints and other crisis situations. The helicopter's ferry range was almost 1,400 miles, thanks to a set of two LHTech T-800 turboshaft engines, each capable of delivering up to 1,563 horsepower. If strategic transport assets were not available at the moment, its range would allow it to fly to overseas battlefields on its own. The Comanche was equipped with sophisticated avionics systems for navigation, communication, and detection to fulfill its missions. They included a digital fly-by-wire flight control system, which was useful for nighttime or bad weather operations. The Comanche also had two identical cockpits for the pilot and co-pilot, sealed with a pressure air system to protect them against chemical and biological warfare. Each of the crew cockpits had LCD multifunctional displays and a helmet-integrated display and sight system. The armament was also an essential part of the program, as the stealth helicopter was expected to engage with both ground and air targets in an active combat zone. To achieve the light attack role, the Comanche was equipped with one chin-mounted 20mm three-barrel rotary cannon that could be pointed. The helicopter was also capable of internally carrying a maximum of six AGM-114 Hellfire air-to-ground missiles, or up to 12 smaller AIM-92 Stinger air-to-air missiles. Other than the internal munitions, the ground crew could mount external stub wings capable of carrying up to eight additional Hellfire missiles, or 16 Stinger missiles, if the mission called for it. However, operations performed with this kind of external mounting would reduce the effectiveness of the Comanche's stealth technology. The Comanche takes to the skies. Although the prototype's first flight was initially slated for August of 1995, structural and software problems kept it on the ground. Then, on January 4th, 1996, the Boeing-Sikorsky RAH-66 Comanche finally flew for the first time in a 39-minute maiden flight piloted by Bob Gradle and Russ Stiles. During the test trials, the aircraft reached a top speed of almost 200 miles per hour and showed solid acrobatic prowess for a helicopter of its size. Not only was the Comanche fast, agile, and powerful, it also produced half of the noise of a traditional helicopter because of its all-composite five-blade main rotor and its tail rotor assembly. Although the rotorcraft could still be heard as it approached, the reduced sound would give the enemies less time to prepare before the mighty Comanche closed in on them. The second prototype flew for the first time on March 30th, 1999. The Army then realized that the aircraft had all the key necessities for their subsequent reconnaissance and light attack helicopter and approved the $3.1 billion engineering and manufacturing development phase of the RAH-66 program on June 1st, 2000. According to the U.S. Army, they planned to purchase 1,200 Comanches, and deliveries would start as early as 2006. An untimely warrior. The first Comanche prototype completed over 300 flights and almost 400 hours before ending its testing career in January of 2002. Meanwhile, the second prototype had accumulated 93 flight hours and over 100 sorties by May of 2001. However, a big problem plagued this stealth helicopter built to scare the Soviet Union. By the time it was ready to fly, the Red Army had already dissolved. Now, without any geopolitical conflict nor the ever-looming threat of nuclear war, the Comanche began to look like a giant pile of problems in the Army's eyes. Although the Comanche had some of aviation's most avant-garde features at the time, as is often the case with first-of-its-kind aircraft, the helicopter came with plenty of technological setbacks and never-ending cost overruns. To begin with, the helicopter was far heavier than initially anticipated, and some of Boeing-Sikorsky's engineers wondered if it would ever get off the ground with its intended weaponry. In addition, according to a report following a series of tests performed in the early 2000s, the Comanche's almost 20-year-old design still had severe technical challenges in software integration, antenna performance, gun system performance, and aided target detection algorithm performance. By the end of the year, Boeing-Sikorsky launched an effort to reduce the aircraft's weight by 200 pounds, or 2.1%, to conform to the initial number expected by the Army. Some of the most prized elements of the Boeing-Sikorsky effort, such as software capabilities and its integration, failed to create enough confidence within the Army, and several of its features were also thought to be too new and risky. But although these issues could have been resolved with more time and money, America's defense priorities shifted after September 11, 2001, and the Army reduced their Comanche orders by half a year later. By then, up to 40% of the aviation budget was assigned to the Comanche alone, and top officials believed it was not worth the hassle. Finally, on February 23, 2004, after decades of development and nearly $7 billion spent on the program, the Comanche program was officially canceled. In a report published in 2008, the Government Accountability Office stated that the Army believed that the program's cost had become unjustifiable. According to author Cindy Williams, quote, "The rationale for cutting Comanche is twofold. First, the doctrinal niche that the Comanche occupies is unnecessary in the near term and probably not viable in the longer term. Secondly, as with all rotary wing aircraft, the Comanche is a voracious consumer of strategic airlift." Post-cancellation. Initially slated for a production run of over 1,000 RAH-66 Comanche helicopters, the program ended up producing only two prototypes. Today, both airframes are showcased at the United States Army Aviation Museum in Fort Rucker, Alabama. Despite the program's apparent failure, Defense Department insiders have indicated that the Comanche is regarded in a positive light. In 2011, years after its cancellation, Deputy Undersecretary of the Army Thomas Hawley was asked about the program's failure and responded that, quote, "I wouldn't say Comanche was necessarily a failure of procurement. Comanche is a good program." Since then, the Boeing-Sikorsky duo has teamed up again to build another prototype, the SB-1 Defiant, as part of the Army's Future Vertical Lift program. The plan is to develop a family of military helicopters with similar features as the Comanche for the United States Armed Forces. Although it is still under development and testing, the Defiant had its first flight in 2019 and shows a promising future. Thank you for watching our Dark Skies video. Please leave us a comment if you know of an aircraft that you'd like to see featured on our channel. And don't forget to subscribe to this and all of our other 7 channels, and hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest content.